Galileo, back in 1600, discovered the idea of inertia, that objects at rest have a natural tendency to stay at rest. Everybody agreed with that. That wasn't the problem, but the difficult part, the revolutionary conclusion that he has was that if an object is moving, it will have a tendency to keep on moving naturally in a straight line at a constant speed. Or it'll move at a constant velocity naturally. It just keeps on doing so. Or an object will not accelerate. It won't change direction, won't change speed unless it's forced to. Now we hear that, and we don't think it was a really big deal because we've heard those words before and we've been taught that ever since we were young children. But it is a big deal. It was a big deal, and it remains so today. What he discovered, inertia, was contrary to what Aristotle believed, and many of us still believe today. 2,000 years before, 350 BC, Aristotle said that objects here on Earth have a natural tendency to stay at rest. So just, if it's there, it's not going to move. And if it's moving, it'll naturally stop. And we think that still today. So when Galileo came up with this idea that objects have a natural tendency to keep moving, it allowed the Earth to move. Prior to that, Aristotle said that the Earth is the center of the universe. It can't move because, according to all the calculations, we would have to be traveling at 60,000 miles an hour going around the sun, or 1,000 miles an hour around the equator of the Earth. Can't happen. So Galileo's new idea allowed the Earth to be set into motion to go around the sun without a problem, because once you get the Earth moving, spinning on its own axis or moving, it will naturally tend to keep moving. Now, to keep it going in that circle that it scribes around the sun, not quite a circle, actually an ellipse, but to keep it moving has to be a gravitational force. Galileo didn't understand that there was a force. He thought that once you get something moving in a circle like the Earth around the sun, it just keeps on going. But once you get it moving, it'll keep on moving, unless there's a force applied to it to slow it down or to change its direction. Why does that boulder or the building or the car in the parking lot just sit there? Well, don't just say inertia. That's a name for the natural tendency. Why do those things just sit there? Because they do. They just do. Inertia is our name for that natural tendency. But really, there's no net force to cause it to start moving, to accelerate. Why does a bowling ball keep rolling or a car keep on rolling down the street? It's because it does. Now, those things will slow down, but they'll slow down or change directions or stop or speed up when there's a net force applied. But when all the forces are balanced in all directions, you don't have any acceleration. It'll keep on moving at a constant velocity, the triumph of Galileo, or it'll just stay there. And until there is a net force applied to the object, that object will move at a constant speed in a straight line or stay right there. Now here's the big test that I often give for your understanding of inertia and Newton's first law of motion. You have a car, and the car is traveling down the highway at 60 miles an hour. It's a flat highway, straight line, constant 60 miles per hour. There are up and down forces, and there are backwards and forward forces. So up and down, which force is bigger? It's on a flat, it's not flying, it's not jumping up and down, it's not digging into the ground. So obviously, the up force balances the down force. But the big question is, which force is bigger? Is it the forward force that's bigger than the backward force? Or is it the backward force that's bigger than the forward force? Remember, constant speed, straight line, that direction. Which force is bigger? Almost all of my students will answer the forward force is bigger than the backward force. And I have them circle it and draw it and make sure and talk about it. We just clearly describe the situation. But almost everybody says that the forward force is bigger than the backward force at a constant speed in a straight line. It's wrong. Everybody thinks like Aristotle more than 2,000 years ago. We haven't even advanced to Galileo's idea from 400 years ago. The fact is that if the forward force is bigger than the backward force, you're going to speed up. And if the backward force is bigger than the forward force, you're going to slow down. So to maintain a constant speed, backward force and the forward force have to be balanced. Balanced forces. Zero net force, no acceleration, no change in speed, no change in direction. Here's a summary. Inertia is just a name for the natural tendency for objects to maintain a constant speed, straight line motion. Isaac Newton made that into his first law of motion. All accelerations are caused by net forces. Any net force will always cause an acceleration, or the superextended version. An object at rest will remain at rest, and an object in motion will maintain a constant speed in a straight line unless acted upon by a net unbalanced external force. That's Newton's first law, inertia.